January 10th, 2023, Canada, baby. Okay, coming at ya. I'm kind of in a crusty this morning, okay, guys? But first off, I'm going to talk about Tent City Weather Report, okay? It's mild out. Texas low storm system has tapered off. It's going to be mild. And after that, I know that we're getting another blast. Getting another blast on Friday, okay, and into the weekend, okay? That is your Tent City Weather Report. Okay, guys, I hope you liked me out in the snow yesterday. That was kind of fun, being out and about. Okay, yeah, so, could you imagine being in the tents? But, you know, at least some of the people living in tents are living in not igloos. However, if we get enough snow, you can make Quincy's and stuff. I made a Quincy once. Not sure if I'm saying that right, but I made a Quincy once, and I think it's, it's from, like, Iqaluit and Nunavut, you know, like up in the Northwest Territories and stuff. Okay, guys? Okay, and then you can just build your typical snow forts if you wanted. You could get those blocks and make little, you know, wow, that would actually be great. The snow is melting. So, anyways, we can't do much with the snow, guys. You can't make an igloo, you can't make a Quincy, you can't make a snow fort. The snow is a good insulator, but now it's really wet, so it's not any good right now, okay, guys? Okay, but we're getting another blast Friday. Okay, all right. Today, okay, I haven't touched on Canadian news, but that's up to you guys to do your research. Okay, guys? I've been talking a little bit about Trump the last few days because I think that's really important because, you know, we got no news here in Canada. You got to really find it. But today, I want to talk about me. I want to talk about I, and I want to talk about number one. Okay, guys? Because I'm getting jerked around again. And I'm not liking it, okay? I got the barn coat on with a tie, okay? All right, and I was kind of leaning on the red and white and black anyways today. I was going to go purple, but then I thought, you know what? Let's get the barn coat on, you know, and have the Canadian colors on because everybody's doing it. Okay, so, okay, we are going to talk about me right now. Okay, we're going to talk about me because I'm trying to help everybody right now, okay? I need a little help myself, okay? So you're going to like, share, subscribe, and get the word out there. We got to spread some stuff, okay, guys? Because I'm trying to help you, but right now I got to talk about me. I got to talk about I got to talk about number one, okay? Here's a little Toby Keith for you. Okay, guys, do you get the drift? Okay, guys, first off, I'm going to recap my whole experience. I wrote it down just so I didn't forget anything because I thought it would make a really good YouTube short so that when people come to my YouTube page, they can see what kind of, I threw the hat away, kind of crap I've been dealing with. But first, I'm going to talk about the trough feeders. I got talking to somebody the other day, a country girl, and she had made reference about trough feeders. And that's how this country got so messed up, because we got trough feeders. What's a trough feeder, you ask? Well, a trough is where animals, livestock, in a barn setting, okay? If you're from the city, okay, I'll break it down, okay? It's a little trough, okay? A little drinking trough. Well, I'll use blue just so everyone knows, okay? This is water, okay? So then you got your livestock coming over and they're drinking and eating out of the trough, okay? So the trough feeders are the ones that let this country get so bad. And what's a trough feeder? Well, a public trough feeder is, oh, geez, feeding at the public trough is using government funds to enrich oneself. Okay? So, basically, everybody's getting a whole bunch of money, okay, to keep their mouth shut, okay? However, people like me that are not getting paid, getting jerked around, I'm getting no money, okay? I have not had money, an income for a month, okay, guys? When I told I would be okay for 26 weeks until my employer got stuff figured out, which they haven't, and neither has my union, okay? So, we got Toby Keith, okay? We're going to do my experience so I can make this into a little short so everybody that comes onto my YouTube page can just see it all, okay? Here's my pen. Okay, guys, here's a recap of my past 2 years. Okay, guys? June of 2021, I became sick. Okay? I have Crohn's and colitis. I've had it since I was a kid. Okay? I had never been so sick. Prior to that, I'm a child and youth worker, and I got attacked by a 17-year-old male. Okay? A few weeks later, I got sick with the old Crohn's and colitis, okay? I was rushed by ambulance to the hospital where I nearly died, okay, from a bowel blockage. When I got to the unloading department at the hospital, I was almost attacked by a crackhead, and that happened several times throughout my hospital stints. My hospital stints included from June to September 2021. I was admitted 6 times in 3 months for 40 days. That's minus my surgery time spent in hospital after my bowel resection. I had home care nurses prior to my surgery. Home care nurses daily for a total of 109 days. I was fed through my bloodline. I couldn't eat. I went 36 days the first time without being fed before finding out I was goofed up on, and I had to go another 73 days without eating. But I don't really blame them, because the hospitals are a gong show, because I was almost attacked several times inside, outside the hospital, okay, so I'm a little understanding. I was unable to vote in the last federal election when I was hospitalized. I lived in a motel. There I experienced violence, drug use going on outside, and I was almost human trafficked one night. I lived in a tent last summer. Had to live off all my savings, pull out my RSPs. I worked last year on a modified program. This year they can't accommodate me. Right now, it's my second time since the fall where I have been a month without an income coming in. No help from my union, about to pull out my pension or start a GoFundMe page, okay? Because I'm really getting tired of that. This has been my life since June 2021. I have barely had a chance to recover, guys, okay? Barely had a chance to recover. Oh, yeah, almost attacked several times inside, outside the hospital. And how do we help others when we can't help people such as myself, who has worked my whole life? And this is unfair to the new Canadians coming in. We're offering them a fake life. A fake life. And people are getting mad, not because people are racist. It's because we are getting oppressed. I am a female. I am Canadian. And I am oppressed. So guys, can we get some work done and get this sorted out, okay? Hashtag House of Commons, hashtag Clown Town. Stay you, stay true, get to talking, and I hope I get some answers today.